myself, Antika Tiwari, from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. I'm going to take the session from Module 3, that is Sequential Circuits, from the subject Digital Fundamentals. The session here we are going to have is on the topic, that is ring counters and Johnson counters. Now, ring and Johnson counters are a special type of counters which depicts some different concept. Now, here the concept of ring and Johnson is based on shift registers. So here we can say that ring counter is the simplest shift register counter. Now, in shift register, we are having many types. In shifting, we are having right shift and left shift. Now, with respect to both shifting, we are having circular shift right and circular shift. So that thing that goes of circular, that means going the value which is dropping at the left side, or the bit which is dropping at the right side, will be continued and it will not be dropped. So this concept is taken in the ring counter. So here in ring counter, we can have any of the flip-flop. The circuit we can have from any of the flip-flop which are given, that is D, D, SR, and JK. But basically we are using D flip-flop. So here the logic diagram is shown as 4-bit shift or 4-bit ring counter. Okay, here take an example. Okay. So here 4-bit, that means 4 flip-flops, that is flip-flop 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, the 4 of the flip-flops are connected with the common clock pulse, which is provided as from 0 to 1 to 0, because here bubble gate is used. That means the triggering of the clock that we are using in this type of counter is negative edge. That means the clock pulse is going from 1 to 0. That is shown by the bubble gate. So here we are using common clock pulse. So each and every flip-flop will have the clock which is provided commonly. That is, here we have used negative edge shift. Okay. Now the concept which is shown in the diagram, as you can see, the D1 value which is inputted will get the value from the last flip-flop output, that is Q4. So from Q4, the output or the value which is dropped from the left shift or from the right shift, if I am talking about, that is shift right. So shift right, that bit will be dropped down. That bit will not be dropped. That will be taken to the first bit. Okay, so this is what shifting goes if it is in shift right. If I'm going from shift left, okay, that means this bit is taken at the last position. It is also not dropped. It is taken at the Q4 position. So this is what D1 value, which is going from Q1 to D2. From D2 value, it goes from Q2 as D3. D3 value taken Q3 as D4, and continue that Q4 value will be taken to the D1. So this is the circuit or the continuous bit or the drop which is taken from last to first is the concept of the ring counter. Okay, so the ring means it is taken in the form of circular form. So here ring structure is being made. So this counter is known as ring counter. Now with respect to this shift register or ring counter, we will take an example. So we can see that a ring counter is a shift register which is in a cascade connection of flip-flops, that is with the output of the last flip-flop connected to the input of the first flip-flop. So this is the basic concept of ring counter. Now we'll take an example. We'll take an example as the first state as 1000. So now the present state is 1000. The next state will be 0100. Now the present state is 0110. Next state will be 0010. Why we are taking one value is going, that is in the forward direction? Because we are not dropping the bit. That bit which is taken forward is going back to the first position. So here if I am inputting one value at the first position, the next value will be taken as 0100. Now if I am taking 0100, the one will be taken to the third position as 001. Now the 0010 we will take as the present state, will take the next state will be 0010001. Now present state is 0001, the next state, this one will go to the first position, that is 1000. So here with respect to 4 bits, we need to have 16 possible combinations. But here we are using only 4. So the other states are wasted in ring counters. Okay, but we are using the 4 condition. That means with respect to 4 states itself, the answer is being So that means we got the answer of the first table. So we can say, we can have this thing in the table also, as you can see in the table, Q0, Q1, Q2. We'll start with the first value, that is 1, 0, 0, 0. Okay, the next state, if I'm taking that first value of Q0, will go to the Q1. So next state of Q1 will become 1. Now, when it is Q1, the next state it will continue to the Q2. Now Q2 is 1, the next state will Q3 will have 1. Now, when Q3 value is 1, when it is taken once again with the shifting process, will get 1 in the first position as the Q0. So Q0 now will become 1. So 4 states, and the next state is the repeating state itself. Okay, so this is what state table is. Waveforms will be depicted with respect to same clock is provided commonly. Okay, Q1 is taken with respect to 0, 1, because here we are taking negative edge degree. So clock pulse, when it goes from 1 to 0, that time Q1 value goes from 0 to 1. Sorry, 1 to 0. Okay, same thing we will take as Q2 will be same thing, 0 to 1. Q3 will be taken with respect to Q2 itself. So Q2, when it goes from 1 to 0, that time Q3 will activate from 0 to 1. Now, when Q3 goes from 1 to 0, okay, that means 1 to 0, that time Q4 will be activated as 0 to 1. So this is what transitions will be taken with respect to clock. In the ring counters, we are having merits and demerits as advantages and disadvantages. In merits, we are having, like we can say that in ring counter, we are having only high state. That means high state means high value, that is one value at any instant of time. So for that condition, we can easily decode the value because at one particular time, the value will be only high. So this is what the advantage of ring counter is. The disadvantage or the demerit of the ring counter is, that is, if we are having n bits of the values, that means if I am having 4 bits, that means the possible combination for the 4 bits are 16. But in ring counter, it is using only n bit states. That means the other bits, that is after 16, the 4, if we are discarding, it means 12 states are wasted in ring counters. So this is the drawback of the ring counter. After ring counter, we are having the another type of counters, that is Johnson counter, that we will be going to study. In Johnson counter, the Johnson counter is also known as twisted ring counter. Twisted, the word twist comes with the concept of negation. That means the in the circuit diagram, we are having the negative value which is inverted to the first position. So the main advantage of this type of ring counter is that it needs only half of the number of flip-flops as compared to the ring counter, that its modulo number is half. So this is the main advantage or the merit or the very good concept of the Johnson counter. Now with respect to Johnson counter, we are also having n state counter. That means in n state, we will circulate a single data, and with a given sequence of different n states, we will get 2 raised to n values. That means if I am taking n, then we will have double the states. We will be using it. That means the wastage of the 4 states or the wastage of the other states which was done in the ring counter is being covered here. So this is what the Johnson counter concept is. Now we'll take the example and we'll see the circuit diagram. Here in the Johnson counter, we are using an example of the state, that is 0000. So here the 0000 state is the present state. Now the next state after 0000 will be 1000. Why? Because the negative value of the last bit is taken to the first bit position. So here the 0 will become 1 at the first bit position. So here 0000, after that it will be 1000. Now one more negation will be converted to 1 value. That means after 1000, the next state will be 1100. Now after that, one more will be active, that is 1110. After that, one more, the last bit will be active, 1111. Now we'll start with 1111, and the next state will be negation of the last value, that is 1 will become 0. So 0111. Now going in the reverse order, 0 will increase by one more bit, that is 0011. After that 0001, and the last state will be 0000. Here A prescribed sequence of four-bit is not followed. That means the concept of negation, that is twisted, is being done with respect to when we are having a state of 0000. See the change of the next state. The first value of 0 has become 1 now. That means it is twisted, the pair, that the last value of negation is taken in the positive value, that becomes 0 to 1. That is followed in each and every state. Okay, this is the pictorial representation of the state or the of the Johnson counter. Now, the next, the thing, the main circuit of the Johnson counter is, as you can see, here we have used 4 states. So, 4 flip-flops. Okay, 4 flip-flops with QA value, QB, QC and QD as an outputs. Okay, now the twisted here, as you can see in the diagram itself, you can see the last value of QD. That Q is the output. Q bar is taken and that Q bar is inserted to the first position of the first flip-flop. This is the twist that we got in the from the ring counter, which has become now the Johnson counter. Okay, now the present state of or the present value will be going in the right direction or it will be going on the left direction. So shift concept will be there, either it is in right direction or either it is in left direction. So here the value which is taken from the last flip flop, the inverted value will be taken and it will be inserted at the first position. So this is the main concept. Clock is given as a common value in each and every flip flop. Reset bit is being set because if I am taking the value of 0000, we have to reach till 0000. So here a pin has been introduced as reset. If I am taking a value at any position, means if it is 1100, we need to reset the value till 0000. So here one concept is been introduced of reset pin. Okay, so this is what the logic circuit is. After logic circuit, we need to have the state table. So here with respect to state table QA, QB, QC and QD, now the initial state is 0000, next state is 1000, same the thing which we have taken in the state diagram, that is being shown here in the form of table with the present state with the next state. Now the repetition will come at the last value is 0001. So now we will repeat the value, that is repeat what is given. We will start with the 0000. So this is what the state table of the Johnson counter is. Now Johnson counter is also known as mode 8 counter because we are covering values from 0 to 7. So 8 values are covered, so it is also known as mode 8 counter. But in mode 8 counter, the sequence which is followed by the thing, that is 0, after 0 it is 1, after 1 it is 2, but here the sequence is not being maintained. Here the concept of Johnson counter, that is the negation or the Q bar, is being taken to the first position of the from the last position. With respect to that, the state will not come in sequence. So this is what the Johnson counter is. Waveforms is depicted and we will get 8 outputs starting from Q0 till Q7. Okay, starting with each and every bit. If I am taking positive clock pulse, Q0 will be active at the positive going of the clock pulse itself. Same thing Q1, which is dependent on the Q0 itself. In Q2, which is dependent on the Q2 value of positive going. Same Q3, same Q4, till Q7. So this is what the waveforms which is being depicted with the state value output of Q0 till Q7. So here the merits or demerits, that is advantages or disadvantages of Johnson counters are, if I am talking about merits, that means advantages, in Johnson counters, more outputs have been generated with respect to ring. Because in ring counter, if I am taking n states, output we were getting as n outputs. But if I am taking in Johnson counter as n states, I am getting output as 2a. That means we are multiplying 2 times of the n and we are getting the outputs. More outputs have been generated with respect to ring counter. The second of the merit in the Johnson counter is the same number of flip-flops is being used, as we cannot count twice. That means if I am taking n and we are getting output as 2n, that doesn't mean we need to have output as 2n. Output we will get as 2n in itself, but the flip-flop that we will be going to take is the number of bits that we are taking it. Now, the third of the advantage of the Johnson counter is when we are having 2 raised to n outputs, but we need not to have 2 raised to n inputs. That means that flip, that many times of flip-flop, we doesn't require it. Half number of the flip-flops we are requiring it in order to get the outputs. Now, the demerits, that is disadvantages of Johnson counter is, if I am talking about 4-bit, means we need to have 16 outputs, but from the 16, how many bits we are using it, how many states we are using it, that is 8. That means the other 4 are being wasted. So this is what the drawback of the Johnson counter. Now, with respect to that, we also have one drawback in Johnson counter, as it doesn't count the binary in sequence. That means after 0 it should be 1, but it is not counting like that. It is with the base, that is the last output which is inputted to the first one, with respect to that concept the output is been coming. So it doesn't follow the binary sequence which goes from 0 to 7. It is going with respect to its concept. So this is what Johnson counter is. In this session we have covered the two types of counters, that is ring counters and Johnson counters. Thank you.